serve God. You are rich towards God in not rich in earthly things. Okay, Jesus tells us it's more important to be rich towards God. So you are rich towards God if you are greedy? No. Can you be rich towards God if you don't share your what you have to the needy? If you think everything is yours, you think you are rich towards God? You live, work, everything for your own? No. You are rich towards God only if you share with the needy. And it's what you have to share. Support the cause of church and kingdom. Seek treasures in heaven and recognize what really belongs to God. You are rich towards God if your first goal in life is to pursue God and Christ rather than earthly treasures. That means your mind focused to find and understand God's new duties, build with obedience rather than how to make more money, how to acquire more land. Outside world actually tells that it's okay, but the Bible tells us no. It's actually not easy. Christians don't fall into this. Okay? Our relationship with God is more important thing than our pleasures and enjoyment. Prayers, Bible readings, attending church in worship must not be neglected. Because you have work to do, you have other activities. If you neglect that, then you are not rich towards God. So that's important. You want to be rich towards God. In conclusions, for one person, greed might take the form of wanting more stuff. The person always thinking about the next thing that he wants to buy, next thing he wants to get. That's one form of greed. But for another person, it might be different. Okay, you may not buy tons of stuff, but when you buy something, you want to buy less. Okay? Won't settle for anything less. That could be also greed. For another person, greed is expressed in their way of living their lifestyle. Craving to have more saving. More saving. They give them a sense of security. They don't spend. See, someone couldn't look at your life and think, oh, they must be greedy because they have all these possessions. But if they could look into your heart and soul, they will see that you are putting your faith in money. You are putting your future into money. Rather than trusting God, you are trusting money. For another person, greed might be expressed in the lack of joy of sharing. Okay? So, of course, you won't buy anything. But you also don't buy anything for other people. Okay? So, greed takes many forms. That's why Jesus said, watch out for many different ways and greed will deceive you. When you are greedy and pursue wealth and riches, you will never satisfy and often end up destroying your life. So, back to the scripture text, 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 9. People who want to get rich fall into temptations and trap into many foolish and harmful desires and plunge back into ruins and destructions. Of course, you may gain the whole world, but you end up losing your soul. Mark chapter 8, verse 36. So, do pursue godliness and contentment. You might lose the world, but you will gain your soul. So, be honest. Greed is not absent from anyone of us. We have greed in us. Whether you are a child that don't want to share your toys, or whether you are an adult who always crave for more. Jesus knows this. Jesus knows this about us. That's why he warns us strongly. Okay? Watch out and be on guard against all kind of risks. Important thing, godliness with contentment is okay. Important thing is people, not things. A small room with love is better than a big room for yourself. Shall we all stand at the closing singing a song of encouragement?
5:45.
Dangers of greed and also the way to overcome this.